Oysters in the Chesapeake Bay are incredibly important. Oyster reefs serve as habitat for a lot of fish and crabs that live right there on the reef. Those smaller species serve as forage or food for bigger species that also come around. So you have all of this life that's revolving around these Chesapeake Bay oyster reefs. Whenever they're eating, they are pulling in the water and actually filtering it for us and pulling out some plankton, algae, and sediment. And really, once pollution gets into the bay, there's not a whole lot of way for it to get back out again, except if it happens to go over an oyster reef. A lot of things that we do actually impact the oysters and their ability to thrive. We estimate that we've lost about 99% of our oyster population. Most of the big oyster reefs had been fished out by about the 1920s. And since that time, there's been a collaborative effort to try to manage the fishery better, to try to work towards some of the issues around pollution and disease that have also hit our oyster populations hard, and to go out there and physically rebuild oyster reefs and plant new oysters on them. A large partnership effort has formed in order to try to bring that oyster population back up in the Chesapeake.
NOAA's a partner in the Chesapeake Bay program's large-scale oyster restoration effort. Our specific role has been to coordinate the development of the blueprint or the tributary plan for restoration. Our specific role on this vessel has been to help develop those plans through benthic habitat survey work. Benthic habitat surveys provide context for bottom structure, depth, substrate, whether they're shell, whether it's mud.
Can you let it sit for a bit? Yeah.
These components are built into the blueprint for where and how we restore oysters in any given tributary.
The Marine Resources Commission's core mission is to act as stewards of Virginia's marine and aquatic resources. Oysters have always been a large part of that mission. What we were watching today was a deployment of close to 1,200 tons of clean ground quarry stone on a reef site that was selected specifically for this purpose. Oysters are dependent on a hard substrate to attach to in their juvenile stage. They're a free-floating larva. And if there's not something hard, like a rock or a piece of shell, they'll just die. So that's why we're putting substrate down. It's the actual hard substrate available for them to attach to and then grow into their adult form.
Whereas Virginia can just go out and put substrate or shell down and they'll get natural recruitment there, Maryland has to go the additional step of getting spat on shell. One shell can hold upwards of 15 baby oysters. That's the whole point of the Horn Point hatchery, so that we can put down actual live oysters instead of just shell. Today we're in the Tred Avon River, planting about 20 million oysters. The goal is to restore oysters closer towards historic population levels. We'll come do 3-year monitoring, and then we'll do 6-year monitoring after that to see how the reef's looking. We can continue to plant if needed, or sit back and watch nature do its wonderful thing.
What our monitoring data has showed us over the last several years is that the vast majority of these reefs that we've built are actually functioning in the way that we had hoped. They have lots of oysters on them across multiple generations, and their structural integrity is persisting. They're staying up off the bottom. They're not getting smothered with sediment or covered with algae. These oyster reefs that we're restoring are in sanctuary areas. The hope there is that by having hundreds of acres of them, that they'll form a whole network of healthy reefs. When they reproduce, not only can they populate the reefs within the sanctuary, they may be able to actually start populating areas outside of that, including the harvest areas nearby. This large-scale effort to restore the Chesapeake Bay's oysters is actually the largest oyster restoration project in the world. Hopefully that will generate a sense of stewardship and mean that these projects will be maintained over the coming decades.